stars are formed in molecular clouds, and depending on the mass they have, they will have a very short life in the case of very massive stars, or a life that will last for billion years, like the Sun. An EGB star is a star that is just at the end of their life. And these objects have the peculiarity that they are very cold. The temperature in the photosphere is around 2,000, 3,000 Kelvin. And under these conditions, all the gas is in molecular form. This is important for astrochemistry because an important fraction of the molecules that we know in space has been detected in these objects, in EGB stars. And they are very important for the formation of dust. Dust is formed around the photosphere of EGB stars, and the processes that led to the formation of dust are crucial to understand how dust evolves during the life of the gas and dust that is ejected to the interstellar medium. And this dust will, after some time, will participate in the life of new molecular clouds that will form new stars, and these new stars will have planetary systems, and the rocky planets in this planetary system will be formed from the dust that was formed in EGB stars. Then for astrochemistry, it's extremely important to understand what are the physical conditions in these objects and what is the chemical composition, because practically all the matter is in molecular form. That means molecules like silicon carbide, carbon clusters, carbon change, radicals, a lot of molecules. Practically 50% of the molecules that have been detected in space has been found in one object, in one EGB star, that is a prototype that is called CW LEO or IRC 102 system. There are two types of EGB stars that are interesting for astrochemistry, those in which carbon is more abundant than oxygen, and those in which oxygen is more abundant than carbon. The chemistry is completely different. Then, for astrochemistry, both types are very important because they form different molecules and also different dust. The dust in carbon-rich objects is essentially silicon carbide, while in oxygen-rich objects, the dust is silicates. And the properties of the two types of objects, carbon-rich or rich, can be derived from radioastronomical observation using the largest radio interferometer like ALMA. ALMA will offer the possibility to study the physical properties very close to the photosphere, and then we are focused on AGBs that are close enough to improve the resolution, the spatial resolution that we can get with the radio interferometers. Carbon-rich are my preferred objects because they show a very complex chemistry, full of radicals, full of carbon chains, full of carbon clusters, that are really important to understand the chemical complexity of these objects, and also the chemical evolution of the molecular clouds that are formed from the gas that is ejected from this object, and also from supernova. Well, Nanocosmos is a project from the European Research Council. It's a synergy project that is led by three PIs, is two Spanish, José Ángel Martín Gago and myself, and one French colleague, Christine Joblan. This project is the main goal is to understand how dust is formed in evolved stars, in AGB stars, and we address several aspects in which astronomers, physicists, chemists, and engineers are working together to understand the processes that led to the formation of dust. Dust is present in this object. This is something that is very well known. We know that since 40 years or 50 years ago. But the way that the dust is formed from molecules and from small clusters to sizes that are typically of 0.5 micron, that means billions of atoms, is something that is a mystery. And then Nanocosmos will try to solve the problem by getting the information about the physical condition using radioastronomical and infrared observations, and using this information to produce laboratory experiments that try to simulate at the best the physical conditions in the photosphere. And the goal, the main goal, is to go from small molecules to grains. And in Nanocosmos, we will build different experimental setups in which we are going to address the formation of silicon carbide grains, silicate grains, and the interaction of these small grains with the gas. Then in Nanocosmos, we are addressing all the physical processes occurring in the envelopes of AGB star. Then for us, it's a challenge. It's a real challenge from the astronomical point of view, but it's also from the experimental point of view, because we want to create in the laboratory real analogs of the dust grains that are formed in the photosphere of AGBs. Then our goal is to reproduce in the laboratory the photosphere of AGBs. It's a real challenge, but we are confident that at the end of the project we will have results that will provide a lot of information about how dust is formed.